We're asked to determine an exponential function that passes through the points negative 1, 5 fourths, and 2, 80. We also want to find the exponential growth or decay rate and the function value when x equals 3. If we have an exponential function in this form here, the base b is equal to 1 plus r, where r is equal to the exponential growth or decay rate expressed as a decimal. A is the initial value or initial amount, which is the function value when x equals 0, and x is the exponent. So going back up to our question, if the function contains the point negative 1, 5 fourths, this means that f of negative 1 must equal 5 fourths. And if the function contains the point 2, 80, this means f of 2 is equal to 80. Notice how we're not given the point where x equals 0, so we don't know the initial value or the value of a or the value of b, the base. So all we'll have to do is set this up as a system of equations and then solve for a and b. So for f of negative 1, we'll replace x with negative 1 and set the function value equal to 5 fourths. So we would have a times b to the power of negative 1 equals 5 fourths. And then if f of 2 equals 80, that means a times b to the second must equal 80. So now we'll solve this as a system of equations. So let's call this equation 1 and this equation 2. So using equation 1, we know a times b to the negative 1 equals 5 fourths. So what we'll do is solve this equation for a and then perform substitution into the second equation. And since we have b to the negative 1 power here, we can multiply both sides of the equation by b to the first. Remember, when multiplying and the bases are the same, we add our exponents. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. B to the 0 would equal 1. So we have a equals, this would be just 5 fourths b. So now we'll substitute this for a in equation 2. So now equation 2 is going to be 5 fourths b times b to the second must equal 80. So we would have 5 fourths b to the third equals 80. And now we can solve for b to the third by multiplying both sides by 4 fifths. So let's go ahead and put 80 over 1. Notice on the left side, the 4 simplify to 1, the 5 simplify to 1. So we have b to the third equals, on the right side, the 5 and the 80 simplify. There's 1, 5, and 5, and 16 5s and 80. 16 times 4 is equal to 64. So we have b to the third equals 64. And now to solve for b, we'll take the cube root of both sides. Or if we want, we could raise both sides to the 1/3 power. Let's go ahead and take the cube root of both sides. So the cube root of b to the third is b. The cube root of 64 is equal to 4, since 4 to the third does equal 64. So now we know b is equal to 4. We now have to find the value of a. So we know that f of x must equal a times 4 to the power of x. Now we still have to find the value of a, or the initial value, and we can do this using the fact that f of negative 1 equals 5 fourths, or f of 2 equals 80. So let's go and determine the value of a on the next slide. So again, if we know that f of 2 equals 80, we can substitute 2 for x, and then set the function value equal to 80 to solve for a. So for f of 2, we would have a times 4 to the second, which must equal 80. Well, 4 squared is 16, so we have 16a equals 80. Divide both sides by 16. We know that a must equal 5. So the exponential function that passes through the two given points would be f of x equals a, which is 5, times our base, which is 4 raised to the power of x. To check this, let's go ahead and graph this function to make sure it passes through these two points. So here's our function graphed in blue. Notice how we have exponential growth, and it does pass through the two given points. So our function is correct, but we're still asked to determine the exponential growth rate and to determine the function value when x equals 3. To determine the exponential growth rate, we need to remember that our base b is equal to 1 plus r, where r is the growth rate expressed as a decimal. So for our function, since our base is equal to 4, we would have 4 equals 1 plus r. Subtracting 1 on both sides, we have r equals 3. Well, 3 as a percentage is 300%, so the exponential growth rate is 300%. Which means each time x increases by 1, the function value increases 300%. And then for the last question, to determine the function value when x equals 3, we need to find f of 3, which is equal to 5 times 4 raised to the third power. Well, 4 to the third is equal to 64, so we have 5 times 64, and 5 times 64 is equal to 320. So now we have our exponential function, the exponential growth rate, and the function value when x equals 3. I hope you found this helpful.